Now the last property is non-metallic character. The tendency of elements to gain electrons in order to attain octet in their outermost shell are considered as non-matter. As we know, non-matters have in their valence shell 4, 5, 6 or 7 electrons. So they need to gain electron in order to complete their octet or to attain the noble electronic configuration of noble gas elements. So for example, let us take chlorine. Chlorine's atomic number is 17, and electronic configuration is 287. So chlorine, to complete its octet, it has to gain one electron and it becomes chloride, an ion, 288. So this is an ion. Now another example is oxygen. Oxygen electronic configuration is 26, atomic number is 8. It has to gain 2 electrons to complete its octet or to become stable, and then it becomes oxide, 2, 8. So an atom is to gain electron, a non-metal is to gain electron in order to become stable, and then they become negatively charged particle known as anions. Now let us understand another important point, that is non-metals are good oxidizing agents. Non-metals are good oxidizing agents. Why? We know that just now we have understood non-metals, they themselves gain electron to complete its oxide. So they themselves get reduced. So non-metals, they gain electron always. Non-metals gain electrons and they themselves get reduced. And they help other elements to lose electron, and that is why they are good oxidizing agents. This is one of the important point which we have to keep in mind. Now let us understand the factors which affect the non-metallic characters. So factors affecting non-metallic character. So there are two points. One is atomic size. Now atomic size across the period decreases, ENF increases, and that is why the element can easily gain electron and non-metallic character increases. If we look at it down the group, atomic size increases and ENF decreases. So non-metallic character decreases. So the smaller the atomic size, greater is the metallic nature, non-metallic nature. Now, next factor is nuclear charge. In the case of nuclear charge, nuclear charge, number of protons increases, so ENF increases and non-metallic character also increases. Now we will understand the trends in non-metallic character. So what happens when we move across the period or when we move down the group? Now we will understand across the period when we move, the number of shells remains the same. If we look at the third period element, all of them are having 3 shells. So number of shells remains the same. And force of attraction increases because number of protons are increasing. So let us understand this. across the period, atomic size decreases. And as atomic size decreases, E and F decreases, number of protons, sorry, E and F increases, number of protons increases, so force of attraction, effective nuclear force of attraction will increase, and the element will easily gain electron. So non-metals only gain electron, so non-metallic character increases across the period. Increases. Now, down the group, what happens? When we move down the group, the number of shells are increasing, and as the number of shells increases, E and F is decreasing. So, atomic size down the group increases. And as atomic size increases, E and F decreases. And therefore, non-metallic character will decrease, because if force of attraction is decreasing, so element will not able to gain electron, and that is why non-metallic character decreases. Now the important point which we will have to keep in mind is, which is the most non-metallic in nature, in whole periodic table, which is most non-metallic. So the most non-metallic element in nature is fluorine, because just now we understood that across the period the size decreases, and if you look at all noble gases are little bit bigger than halogens, so fluorine being the smallest of all and has highest effective nuclear force, that is why it will easily gain electron. Thank you.